From bedrooms to Black America, New Orleans and back again. I see my people stay acting like we the best. What happened? The point is all the rapping. You signed on, it's what happened. You drop one, never rap again. And when you do it, bust a gas again. The signing bonus make you feel good. Then you swear yourself with a real hood. Gonna stay local, that's small time. You can't need us, and it's all time. I spark them lighters, let it shine. Let them know this is all time. I spark them lighters, let it shine. Let them know this is all time.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Pro Wrestling 225 St. Patrick's Day Beatdown. I'm your host, Robert Tadgett, and alongside me here, none other than Fast Eddie. Well, I can't say that's a surprise, Nick, after the recent events when he Referee Jordy put his hands on an active competitor, none other than Michael White.
A lot of people say that Mike White had it coming to him, but Jordy finally stood up for himself. Finally getting what he's got.
Anyway, that's the start of things off on a bad note. We're going to start off on a good note. Speaking of notes, at this time, I'm going to ask you all to stand. Please help me welcome to the ring.
She's not into you.
Our new Pro Oh, come on, get your hands off Ron Sterling. Michael White, of course, back with a vengeance after his return last show. And his victory over the Minotaur, which I got to be honest with you, Nick, I didn't see that one coming.
Outlaws coming out here like some true gangsters.
More like true bullies.
I know I am.
brotherhood could survive such a conflict like that.
I wonder who this crowd of Blackmen would root for in a match like that.
They might just walk out. Exactly. I don't know if people want to watch two guys from Alabama fight. I mean, you can see that tomorrow, any night of the week. It's free.
Stay classy.
Brought up the recruiting violations that I mean to do. But anyway, moving on.
Ladies and gentlemen, winning this afternoon in Superbus match.
Just missed the ball. wrist tape to his advantage. And now, once again, the referee's back, sir. Come on. This is just a spectacle, Nick.
Jamie Christensen, our new referee, taking the place of Jordy.
Obviously, he's new. They should have kept him in ref school this year. Oh! Oh, come on, now she's getting in the ring. Referee, you might want to watch her defense for a change.
Disqualified here.
Oh, she got caught, literally, in the act. But wait, Nakora looks her down and she's a gentleman. He didn't want to slap a woman. Oh. Sounded.
Well, it already looks like we've got another referee here. I didn't get the memo of the second referee.
No, I didn't either, Nick. Nice. Over the corner, flips him down to the canvas. The game changer with a vicious kick to the back. Oh! Right kick to the back of the head.
Well, Christian Blake's got to use his quickness and his strong style here against the bigger Trucker Jones, who is about twice his size.
Unlike our last contest, which was about as even a matchup as you could get, both on paper and physically, this one is the exact opposite. We've got Trucker Jones in there, maybe about 300, close to 400 pounds a man, and then Christian Blake, who, as you said, has to keep this one moving fast or else he may get squashed.
Speed versus size here.
The classic battle. Let's see who comes out on top. Both men sizing each other up.
And that's not to discredit Trucker Jones either, who is pretty quick for a guy his size and can get around this ring.
Yeah, quick, maybe if he's like running to the fridge to get a hot pocket.
I'm going to tell him you said that.
No, I'm not scared of any Bama people. Oh, they're locking up. Test of strength. And it looks like, slowly but surely, oh yeah, Trucker Jones is going to win this one.
Every single time.
It looks like Christian Blake should have thought a little bit longer and harder about this one. Oh, he's wrenching back on those fingers.
And you got to just think that these Plaquemine fans pretty much always will root against Trucker Jones as long as he's toting that Roll Tide Alabama uniform.
Yeah, the only person they'd boo more would probably be Nick Saban himself.
Well, and I would imagine they even associate Christian Blake with being representing LSU, which couldn't be further from the truth.
Here we go. He's working his way back up. I got to say, I'm impressed. Can he make it over the top? Yes, he can. He's got Trucker Jones now. I guess that strength might go to Trucker Jones in this situation, but endurance definitely is on the side of Christian Blake.
Well, and Christian Blake is no stranger to the ring, as he's been tearing it up here in Pro Wrestling 225 for years.
I think Trucker Jones has a handful of hair, forcing Christian Blake back into the turnbuckle. Come on, Ralph, thumb to the eye. I'm well aware of Alabama people and their favorite hobby, which is cheating. But this is just getting ridiculous.
Hey, if the ref doesn't call it, it's not a foul. Oh! And a big clothesline there. It looked like Christian Blake was trying to clothesline him as well, but didn't have quite the effect.
Trucker Jones down on top. One, two. Only a count of two. What college did you go to, by the way, Nick? By any chance, was it anywhere around Tuscaloosa?
No, it was not. I actually went to UL Lafayette, and I always had a grudge against LSU because they would always take all the funds.
Well, I heard you took the funds, Nick, from your own school. But that's a different story. I guess it was never proven in court.
A different story for a different day, Robert.
Elbow to the back of the head. Trucker Jones now wrenching in that reverse chin lock, trying to cut off the air supply to Christian Blake.
Well, and the more that Trucker Jones keeps this battle on the ground, on the canvas of the mat, the more it's his advantage.
Exactly right, Nick. And if this match keeps at this pace, then we won't be talking very much longer, that's for sure. It'll be over with.
Trucker Jones is squeezing the life out of Christian Blake.
It's times like this that I really don't think the fans can appreciate just how devastating a hold a reverse chin lock can be. It may look simple to these people. Some of them might have already been in it at the hands of their big brother at one time or another. But when you talk about 300 pounds just leaning down on your back and a big arm cutting off your air supply, yeah, it can definitely take a toll on you. As you can see, because Christian Blake still isn't on his feet, but now he's got the cover. Count of two.
Trucker Jones got some of the rope before three.
Good ring awareness.
This referee is showing some promise here.
Christian Blake taking a moment to shed a little bit of clothing. I don't know if that's for the ladies or just to cool himself off. Oh, nice kick to the solar plexus. Oh. another one to the hamstring. You want to talk about a way to loosen up those hamstrings, Nick, that'll definitely do it. If you can chop out those big tree trunks of the big man, get him off his feet, you've got a lot better chance to win this match. Oh, no. Oh!
What a neck breaker there by Trucker Joe.
Is there even a name for that? Two and three quarters, about as close as you can get without getting the victory.
Wow.
That was one of the most devastating maneuvers I've ever seen, Nick. I've got to hand it to Trucker Jones. He just dropped the back of Christian Blake's head right on his knee.
You got to hand it to Christian Blake for kicking out of that.
Trucker Jones got a hold of that arm now. Wrenching back on it, trying to rip it out of the socket.
Blake's got to get to his feet.
Once again, like you talked about earlier, Nick, Trucker Jones trying to slow down the match. Lean all that body weight on Christian Blake. Keep him on the ground. That's the secret to his success. But Blake trying to fight out of it now. Big forearms to the side of the head, and now get a little momentum. Oh! Takes him down. But I think he's wasted time, Nick. He's playing to the fans, but he's letting a lot of time pass here.
Blake's got to stay on Trucker Jones. You can't let him get back in this thing. You're right, Robert. I hate to say that.
I know you do. I don't get to hear it off. Oh, missed the kick. Trucker Jones gets him up on his shoulders. Oh! You've got to hand it to Trucker Jones. He's got quite a move list.
Attitude adjustment.
Exactly. I don't know what to call him exactly. It's
Alabama adjustment.
An Alabama adjustment. Got him up with the lights, drops him down for the one, the two, and almost three again.
Once again, he waited too long to cover him.
I'm going to have to take a trip to the back one of these days, Nick, and ask Trucker Jones in person what these moves are called, because no one's more innovative at coming up with new maneuvers than Trucker Jones. I mean, that looked to be a Death Valley driver almost into a back suplex.
Well, as we said, he might don't let his size fool you, because Trucker Jones can move around this ring, and he's definitely got some strength and agility.
Oh!
And a knee right to the jaw!
Earth-shattering knee right to the jaw, as you said. One, two,
that's gotta be
three!
It.
That's it!
Size of the fight and the dog that matters. Playful can't keep on avoiding
fake news. Let me tell you, New School Clayton Cool is not afraid whatsoever of Robert Godsey. Now, that might not be the smartest thing that he could do. I'm scared of the man. I'll admit that freely. But Clayton Cool has got that self-confidence, and that's going to serve him well tonight in this match, because if he didn't have confidence, I don't want to think about what would happen.
Robert Godsey's also got the extra motivation of it being St. Patrick's Day.
Yes. That's what I said. That's what I was pointing out earlier, Nick. Everything seems to be in the favor of Robert Godsey involving this match. It's St. Patrick's Day. It's a Glasgow street fight. Of course, we know Robert Godsey. Irish heritage, his heritage. He's literally, this is right up his alley.
He's part of a new look tonight.
And we've seen those vignettes he's shot over the past few weeks challenging New School Clayton Cool. He looks darker, more sinister, and to be honest, a hell of a lot more scary than he's ever looked before.
Even though he is tapping into the darkness, still sporting his green, which, by the way, Robert, you're not sporting your green. I'm going to have to let Robert Tanger know so he can come back here and pinch you.
Don't even try it, Nick. I only let the ladies pinch me. No disqualification, you heard it here, folks. Second, he turned his back, and that big shark, Robert Godsey, almost grabbed him just that quick. Here we go. We're underway. Godsey offering his hand, but in a Glasgow street fight, I have a feeling handshakes aren't the usual kind of fare you'd expect in one of those kinds of matches. I don't blame Clayton for being hesitant to shake hands with this grizzly bear.
Let's see if Robert Godsey's attitude fights his in-ring ability, as if he wasn't already brutal enough before.
They lock up. Godsey pushes Cooley into the corner, wrenching back on his face, just shoving him back into the turnbuckle. Backs off. You can tell he's just toying with Cooley at the moment. It's like a shark just playing with its prey. The fans, though, starting to get behind Clayton Cool. Lock up again. Cooley, go behind. Who's going Clayton Cool? Oh! Hammering into the midsection of Godsey. Now he changes to the front face lock.
You got to hand it to Clayton Cool. Getting some offense here on Godsey.
Gator rolls him over.
Using his pure technical skill.
Yeah, but unfortunately, that can only last so long in this match. And just that fast. Oh, big elbow down to the back of
right
New School Clayton Cool, yeah. Such a simple maneuver, but you can bet it does a lot of damage.
On his face. As we said, these two definitely do not like each other.
There's no love lost whatsoever. There's been stories going around the back, my friend. Let's just say these two have never gotten along, be it in the locker room, be it outside the locker room, be it in the ring, anywhere you want to talk about. They just plain hate each other's guts.
Shots shot to the side of the face.
And I think that when New School Clayton Carr won that Southern Heavyweight title, that was just all the more reason Robert Godsey had to go after New School, because he wanted not only the title, but to cause New School that pain of losing the title. Big clothesline.
Head off.
I don't like the way this is looking. This is not looking good for New School Clayton Cool.
One is a complete fluke that Clayton Cool won the Southern.
No. Get off it. Get off it, Nick. I thought they told you, management told you there'd be no drinking during the St. Patrick's Day event.
As long as you drink, it doesn't matter, Robert. Clayton Cool reversing that. What a fool.
Back dropping Robert Godsey over. What a display of strength for New School Clayton Cool. I wouldn't even think he could get the big man over like that.
Using Robert Godsey's weight and momentum against him.
Clayton Cool sinking in that wrist lock, wrenching down on it. And now taking him all the way down, ramming his fist into the mat. That's a good way to break a fist. Going over for the cover. Tries to hook the leg, but didn't even get it since then. Only a count of one. This match is just going way too slow. Heck, way too slow for Clayton Cool.
Punting him right in the gut.
This is one of the things I was worried about going into this match, Nick. The pace of the match is snail slow, and that is bad news for Clayton Cool. Oh! Baseball slide, and it just sent Clayton Cool maybe even 3 or 4 feet onto that concrete floor into the ring rail. And now...
he's just taking a beating.
And now, really, really bad news for Clayton Cool. This fight has just gone to the floor. Oh my God, I don't even know what are those?
As you remember, no disqualification.
Oh!
Got several, what it looks like, metal bars in the ring.
Who put metal bars underneath the ring, Nick?
Which is a Glasgow street fight.
Yeah, but I had
do
no idea.
Do you know what's in Glasgow?
No, metal Nick, bars, I know. Metal bars, evidently. You're right. What I want to know is, why are they under our ring?
What got there?
I don't even, is that a... Plate? Paper plate? That's not the most devastating thing I can think of, but okay. New School Clayton Cool looks like he's searching for something to even the odds, but oh no. Look up, Clayton. Oh, God.
I'm not sure what he hit him with there.
I don't know, but I know that's a stop sign.
Oh.
Oh, God, a stop sign right to the back of New School Clayton Cool.
Clayton Cool running a stop sign, getting in a wreck.
This is exactly what I was afraid of when I heard about this match, Nick. Come on! Why is there a door under the ring? Will someone please explain this to me?
Oh! Liberal kick.
Let me guess, is there a kitchen sink under there too?
Robert Godsey is literally throwing the kitchen sink at him.
Well, that's probably next. Oh, oh, what was that?
What's that?
I think he just hit him with the box of Lucky Charms, Nick. Okay. Oh, wait. Wait, there's something in those Lucky Charms. It's a weight. He had a 20-pound weight hidden in a box of Lucky Charms. I guess that was the horseshoe. Oh! Now.
And Clayton Cool looks like a little leprechaun out there.
There you can see he might be just the leprechaun you need to sneak in a victory here. Indeed, but you can see how resourceful he is. Don't count him out yet, Nick. This kid's got a lot of fight in him. He is the reigning, defending Southern Heavyweight Champion of PW225, and he's not just going to hand that belt over, I'll tell you that much.
Looks like we got a half of the door.
Nails him with that plate. I don't think that's going to do too much, though. I'd use something else. Oh, my God, he just rolled right over him. All of his weight under the top of him.
Maybe we get Lucha Liqueur out here, and then we'd have a luchador.
I'm never going to be safe from your bad jokes, am I? Am I? I didn't even talk tonight because of you.
Robert Godsey just throwing the door on top of Clayton Cool. Yes, you heard me right.
Yeah, I was going to say, if there was a poll going on things I would not hear Nick Fuqua say in this year, I would not think I'd ever hear anything about someone using a door in a match.
He's bending that metal rod across of his back.
Now what? What is going on? He's lining up the door in the turnbuckle. I guess he's going to try and... Oh! New school Clayton Cool going to work on Robert Godsey now with that iron bar. Maybe it's a branding iron. I don't know what the hell it is. A curtain rod? Nails him. Now, see, this is what New school has to do. He's got to find an equalizer to knock this big man down to size. And that's exactly what he's doing. One shot.
Fancy way of saying grab a weapon and defend yourself.
It's a street fight, Nick. Oh, God. Just that quick, there went the advantage.
Well, if you compare the impacts on the bars, whenever Robert Godsey hit Clayton Cool, the bar bended. Clayton Cool didn't do nearly the amount of damage.
This Robert Godsey is nothing short of a monster. He's a monster, Nick.
Somebody already punched through that door.
Well, it wouldn't
surprise me if it was Robert Godsey.
I think he has bad intentions right now concerning that door. Oh, God, he's setting him up for please no. Please no, ref. Oh, no. Powerbomb. I was scared he was going to powerbomb him through that door. Two. No. 2 3/4.
Clayton Cool just getting his elbow up.
He will not sit down, Nick. I told you. He spent his entire life working his way to the top to get that Southern Championship, and he's not just going to hand it away just like that to this big man.
Godsey's got a couple options, a couple different doors to open here.
No, wait. He puts on the brake. He's trying to whip Clayton Cool into that door. He's got two to choose from. Trying to whip him in, but no, reversal. Oh! Right into that door.
And the leprechaun, Clayton Cool, getting some of his little pot of gold. Maybe finding his pot of gold in the turnbuckle.
Exactly. Maybe some last second luck is just what this kid needs. He's got the big man down. Now he's got to take advantage. Pulls him over for the cover. Two. Oh! We're talking inches. Inches for him retaining the title.
And Clayton Cool is just like a gnat that's flying around your head. It just won't go away.
And it's exactly what he's like. But if I were you, I'd use a hornet for the analogy instead, because unlike a gnat, Clayton Cool can definitely put the sling on you. Oh, wait, Godsey rolls him up in a small package. No.
Yeah, two there.
This one's been going on for a lot longer than I thought it would, to be perfectly honest with you, Nick. Oh, God, another big boot to
the
head.
Godsey has to do is roll him over and hit him.
One of those will put your lights out for good, I'm here to tell you.
Clayton's got to be out.
Puts him up on his shoulders. Oh, I don't like where this is going. I don't like where this is going.
That's gotta be it.
Oh!
How does Clayton Cool keep kicking out?
It's 100% pure heart, Nick. That's all I can say.
Is it guts or is it just sheer stupidity, Robert?
No, it's guts and it is heart. And nobody has more heart than this kid, and I'm here to tell you that. I know it from personal experience. But even I'm amazed right now. I didn't even know he had this much heart.
That's one thing Clayton Cool can take a beat. That's pretty much just what he's done here tonight.
The question is, can he take much more? Godsey, T-Bone, you back through the door! Dear God! Come on, ref, come on!
Godsey calling that one the welcome mat.
And three, that's
we
it.
We got a new Southern Heavyweight Champion, Robert Godsey. Why don't you run to the ring and do it now, Robert?
Shut up, Nick. Southern Heavyweight Champion, and it hurts me to say that.
Finally, we have some pride restored to the Southern Heavyweight Championship.
Pride? He's going to work on it with the belt after the damn match is over. What are you talking about, pride? This guy disgusts me, man.
Well, hey, it's not called St. Patrick's Day beat down for nothing. A new heavyweight, Southern Heavyweight Champion, Robert Godsey.
Yeah, Jimmy.
Assassin.
Maybe Southern Heavyweight Champion, my butt. Maybe Southern Ireland. Please, can we get someone in there to check on New School Clayton Cole? He's still down. The man got
bad way right now.
The man got put. He got T-Bone suplex through a damn door.
I'm not sure if he's even realized that he's lost that title yet.
He probably hasn't even realized where he is. Can we please get somebody out here? Don't know we have a medical crew in the building.
Godsey walking out.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest is scheduled for one fall.
Thank God we got it.
It is a six-man tag match.
Here we go, Nick. Time for some six-man tag team action.
And the heathen's coming out.
You want to talk about three men without a mission to their name now, Nick. These three men used to be in cahoots and run the roads with Bret the Brett Thibodeau, but ever since he joined the Outlaws with Black and White, now these guys don't really have a direction in PW225. So they ended up in this match where we'll see what they can make of themselves. But I don't know, they put three pretty good athletes to pick a fight with. Batter up!
Team Boom is back in the building.
Pro Wrestling 225. And I'm just amazed with the talent that we have here on the roster, Robert.
Oh, yeah. Not only is this a great matchup of new and old, but it's also going to be one hell of a throwdown here. And if there's one thing I know about St. Patrick's Day, Nick, there's nothing like a good old fist fight to kick things off. And here we go. It's breaking down already. All 3 men in the ring going at it, tooth and nail. Oh!
A three-way collision here.
The Heathens meeting in the center of the ring, but not the kind of meeting you'd necessarily want to have.
I'll tell you what, the Rocket, Wild Thing, and
Mustang Mike
all have the experience over the Heathens, but I'll tell you what, the Heathens have a lot more hair.
Oh, that's really going to help them, Nick, let me tell you. Oh, slingshot over the top by Wild Thing. He just took out all 3 men in one fell swoop from above. Sometimes I think the man is half condor, Nick.
Well, you know Mustang Mike still has in the back of his mind that he wants to get back his title.
Mustang Mike there doing a little fake out, pretending he was going to try a nice suicide dive over the ropes, but then thinking twice about it. Wise choice in my estimation. Now here they go trying to decide who's going to start the match off. Paper, rock, scissors.
Guys are having some fun out there.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oh, Rocket down over with the fist press, putting the fist to the face of this young member of the Heathens. Oh, big clothesline almost took him right out of his boots.
Rattles.
Another one. Here comes another member of the Oh, Rocket with a double axe handle to the center of the back. Hunter Adams is taking a beating here. Rocket sending the youngster in and coming in after him. Oh, but he gets back, body dropped over the top for his trouble. Manages to stay on the apron though. Leap top over the top into a DDT.
Super DDT there by the Rocket.
This one's moving a little fast, a little too fast for even me to call, Nick. Good God. Now Rocket picking up Hunter Adams. Oh, swinging him right into a diamond cutter-like maneuver. So far, I gotta say, Nick, this is not looking well for the Heathens. It's almost like a varsity versus JV matchup.
You're right about that, Robert. The Heathens gotta get their act together here if they wanna stand a chance.
And here comes C-Fang, as he's affectionately called, among the ranks of the Heathens.
C-Fang, the biggest member of the crew.
And here comes the biggest member of exactly. One of the biggest guys in the PW225 area code, for that matter.
The former heavyweight champion.
Mustang Mike locking up, taking the kid into a headlock.
And as we heard from Big Ramp earlier on, Bill Gracie not here tonight, our heavyweight champion.
Oh, God! What a shoulder block!
Well, believe me, Mustang Mike will have his rematch here soon.
He definitely should. You want to talk about a man that's earned it. Here they lock up again, this time C-Fang grabbing Mustang Mike in the headlock. Two shots to the gut. Sends it in. Oh, Mustang Mike with another shoulder block, but this time it didn't quite have the same effect it did last time. The kid's actually pretty sturdy. Oh, moved to the midsection. Mustang Mike going for the suplex.
One there by Mustang Mike.
Only a count of one though, and smartly the kid makes the tag, and in comes JTM. What does the JTM stand for, Nick? Do you know? You're friends with these guys.
Not quite sure of that one.
Now Wild Thing making his first official appearance in the match. Locking up with JTM. JTM taking Wild Thing in that headlock. Cranking down on it, squeezing the neck.
Wild Thing, a local favorite here. Most
definitely. These people love them some Wild Thing. Shoots him into the ropes. Big shoulder block by JTM. Sends Wild Thing down. Takes a minute to look at him, stare him down. Oh, beautiful leapfrog. Oh, look at that drop kick. He drop kicked the soul right out of that kid's body. the Heathens deciding to fall back for a moment, have a little powwow and try and rethink this whole thing.
Well, and with the Rocky Wild thing and Mustang, you've got three former champions or future champions in the case of the Wild thing, and it's crazy that all three of these egos can coexist. Because you know they all want to be in the title picture.
Yeah, Nick, but there's no big egos there. These guys are, all three of them are three of the most humble, down-to-earth guys you'd ever want to meet. They're all just great human beings.
I'd say it's only a matter of time before they show their selfishness.
Oh, come on! Come on! Oh, look at that! Oh, the Wild Thing takes to the skies! And comes flying into the turnbuckle.
Nice move there.
Now putting the boots to JTM, is that? No, I'm sorry. C-Thang.
Varsity versus JV to a certain degree.
Yeah, C-Thang.
The Heathen's got to make a move here.
I've got to be honest here. Having to say the name C-Thang makes me feel like less of a broadcast journalist. I'm just being honest. Big suplex by the youngster. He's got Wild Thing down, but in comes Rocket to make the save. I gotta be honest, it's just so weird to see Rocket and Wild Thing working together so well. These two used to hate each other's guts, but then recently, all of a sudden, both men having a change of heart, and now they're thick as thieves.
Good point there, Robert. These two feuded for a good while, and they seem to be coexisting well tonight. Although the Heathens, on the offense,
Oh, here comes Wild Thing. Big splash in the corner. The former 2016 winner of the Mayor's Cup Challenge, none other than the Wild Thing, won it right here into the Copac Arena, by the way.
Still to come tonight in our main event, we have the finals of the Mayor's Cup Championship, Frankie Thomas and Christian Blake.
Exactly, the 2018 edition. And we'll see who takes the trophy home tonight when that match finally goes down. Hunter Adams whipping Mustang Mike into the turnbuckle and following him in for the big splash. This kid's got blue chip prospect written all over him. But he just got thrown all the way across the ring. Mustang Mike is not going to go down that easy.
These fans getting behind old Mustang Mike. Favorite.
Mustang Mike's got the control back now. Whips the kid in. Big boot to the gut. Looks like he's setting him up for another suplex. Lifts him up. Oh, he's keeping him up there. Oh, wait. Here comes everybody. This one's breaking down. I would say the referee's losing control, but I don't think he ever had it.
Oh! Drops Hunter Adams.
He was up there a long time. All that blood rushing to the rushing to his head. And now Mustang Mike all the way up to the second rope. And here comes the boom!
The boom drop.
You got it.
A cover here, and this one's over.
That might be all she wrote. One, two, no, two and a half. The Heathens were already halfway in the ring to break that one up there, so I don't know if he would have got it. Regardless, I don't know if he would have got the count. Double team maneuver here. Rocket Mustang.
Double elbow.
Now Rocket following it up with another leg drop.
Hunter Adams just taking a beating here.
We've seen more leg drops in this match than we would on a Hulk Hogan DVD box set. Hunter Adams literally getting beat down here at St. Patrick's Day Beatdown. And now he makes the tag. In comes JTM. And he's unfortunately just in time to meet. None of the Wild Thing, but oh wait! Maybe the Heathens have finally figured this thing out because they've managed to get Wild Thing in the worst place he could possibly be, in their own corner. Now up, not the referee distracted. You can see the Heathens going to work on Wild Thing in that corner. Oh, fist to the face, choking him, putting the boots to him. And now they've got him outside the ring. Hunter Adams rams his head into the ring apron.
Referee's got a lot to follow around here. Six-man tag.
You're not lying. It's hard for even the best referee to keep track of six men at once.
And as we heard earlier tonight, we've got a new GM, Mr. Jordy Poolhall,
none other than former referee Jordy. You're right.
And later tonight, we will have our inaugural tag team title match for the PW tag team title. And you got to think whoever wins this match could be in line possibly for a tag team title match.
True. JTM here with the advantage over Wild Thing. You gotta hand it to the Heathens. They are figuring this out slowly but surely. Here they go. Oh, double boot in the corner. They ran Wild Thing's head right into two boots. Oh, look at this. Hunter Adams raking Wild Thing's eyes right across that top rope. Gotta give these young pups credit. When this match first started, it wasn't looking good for them, but now they're showing off their endurance, showing off that pedigree they've got, and they're really putting a beat down on Wild Thing. I mean, if Wild Thing isn't careful, these kids, oh, nice rolling neck breaker.
And that's what you have to do as a good tag team, cut the ring in half, keep them in your corner.
See,
that's exactly what they've done in the Wild Thing.
Oh, yes. Thing now locking down that reverse chin lock on Wild Thing. These fans are starting to get on their feet though. Mustang Mike's getting them going. They're rooting on Wild Thing. Wild Thing fighting back with two hands to the midsection. Comes back in. Oh! Two. And almost a count of three.
Ain't nothing but a seat thing, baby.
Please never do that again.
Sorry about that. And as you said, Rocket and Wild Thing have been longtime rivals. But Rocket is out there to help him just a little while ago. So it seems as though they're getting along, but they're trying to help their friend, but it just has not worked.
Exactly.
Keeps cutting him off.
Mustang Mike trying to get in there to help his teammate, but he's doing more harm than good because meanwhile in the corner, you can see the Heathens double teaming Wild Thing, slingshot him over the top rope into the suplex. Good God, that's got to rearrange your internal organs.
And the Wild Thing is taking some serious punishment here from the Heathens.
You can have all the fans in the world as Wild Thing spawning out, but it won't necessarily do you much good if you're in there trying to fight 3 men at once. Oh, look at this. The Heathens are just everywhere. Boots to the midsection. This big man known as C-Thang really working over Wild Thing. He's got the size advantage, and he's exploiting it to the fullest extent that he can. Oh, there it is!
Super kick.
Super kick right to the jaw, C-Thang. And he makes the tag. Here comes Mustang Mike. He's going right after Hunter Adams. Oh, but wait, the ref. No, come on, ref. Come on. He made the tag. We all saw it.
See the tag.
We all saw the tag, ref. What are you doing?
Well, it seems like the ref keeps cutting them off, but there seems to be three Heathens in the ring almost at all times.
You want to talk about a travesty of justice? I know Jordy's the new general manager, but maybe we need to get him back in a striped shirt because we need some new zebras out here. This could very well cost the team of Wild Thing, Mustang Mike, and Rocket the match. Down at your, oh my God, it was, if that referee's hand was maybe an inch away from hitting the mat for a third time.
Very
now,
Wild Thing's got to make a tag here.
Hunter Adams in now, but look at this. C-Thang makes the tag. They've got the man pinned down in the corner, just putting the boots to him.
Showing great teamwork here.
I agree. I hate to admit it, but yes, they are. These kids are really taking it to the Wild Thing. He's been in there way too long. Wild Thing trying to fight back and make his way into his own corner, but so far he hasn't been able to. Oh, look at this. They're battling it out. Oh, nice kick. Enziguri right to the back of the head. But Wild Thing's too tired. He's just a little too woozy to know which direction he's going. Oh, God, he's going to the wrong corner. His teammates trying to root him on to let him know which way to go, but the kids might as well be on Beale Street after a rough night.
JTM trying to make a tag as well.
Now he's going the right way. Can he make it? Did he get it? And the referee saw it this time.
And here comes Mustang against Hunter.
Oh, Mustang back with a big clothesline. Another big clothesline. Scoops him up and slams him down. Almost puts a hole in the mat. Takes out C-Thing. One big right hand to the back. Another.
Here comes JTM in the ring as well.
Oh, from behind. And here comes C-Thing back.
The referee's got to get him out of the ring.
Yeah, this referee is worthless. He can't keep control to save his life. Slingshot over the top. Oh, yeah!
I guess there was a tag made that I did not see.
One, two, but oh, the count gets broken up again. Meanwhile, Rocket's up on top. I don't know what's happening here. Right hand by Mustang Mike. Another right hand. He's going to town on Hunter Adams. Rocket going back up to the top. Oh, Blockbuster!
And does the referee know who the legal man is?
I have no idea if he knows. I don't even know, Nick. I'm pretty sure Mustang Mike is the legal man, but I don't know who's in for the Heathens. C-Thang answering that question, I suppose. He comes in.
Once again, no tag made.
Takes up the fight. Whips up Mustang Mike.
C-Thang.
Wild Thing's going to the top. I don't think the kids. Oh! Frog splash! He got him in midair. Two, three, that's all.
So was C-Thang even the legal man?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It does not matter, Nick. This one.
A little bit of
Proud of them just for putting up with you, Nick. They deserve a medal for that.
Number 9, 0, 2, 6, 8, 7.
I'm quite sure you did.
9, 9, 0, 2, 6, 8, 7. Where are you? Stand up. That man up there. Don't worry about that. I don't trust this guy. He looks shady. This is shady. Check your shoulder out. Don't take it out! That's the ball.